Hello, my name is Darshan Shah. I'm a director in the product marketing group at Gigamon, and joining me is Matt Hollingsworth, a senior solutions engineer in the public sector group at Gigamon. We're going to be talking about how you can meet M21-31 requirements using Gigamon. Now, we recognize that many of you are scrambling. There is a timeline coming up with the EL1 tier in August of 2022. And we're going to be talking a little bit about how you can address this, especially the maturity model for log management that's addressed in M21-31. And this is really important because this is all about enhancing the federal government's investigative and remediation capabilities. So we're going to give you some takeaways on M21-31, and then we'll talk about a proven solution that will help you satisfy requirements. So with no further ado, Matt, please take us through briefly on the different tiers and then key takeaways.
Sure. So M21-31 is organized into three enhanced logging level categories. Anything that's on the network, it seems, endpoints, servers, network devices, security devices, creating logs, it's all being spelled out. It's almost that we have to capture everything from every part of our network, be it physical, virtual, or cloud. Enhanced logging level 2 adds to this, adds a packet capture with a decrypted data element. It's further expanded by monitoring containers, user behavior monitoring, but ultimately what we're doing is providing centralized access for all of this information so that other agencies can help us prosecute our security investigations. It's a big lift. There's a lot of information here. One interesting change that I've noticed is that the traditional idea of what a log is now different. It's including metadata derived from live packets and also the packets themselves in the form of long-term packet capture. And I think this is especially important for a zero trust building block, because why would you trust a machine logging about itself to be the source of truth about that machine? It could be compromised by an attacker, or it could be turned off or misconfigured. So to add that network information is key for a zero trust effort.
Thank you so much for that, Matt. And so let's talk about some accelerators Gigamon can offer for M21-31. Please take us through this slide.
Sure. Because of Gigamon's position as a deep observability pipeline and also a next generation packet broker, we're in a unique position to accelerate the M21-31 efforts for customers in various ways. I distilled this down into three different ways, because we don't have to configure thousands of devices. All we need to do here is turn the Gigamon on, configure it once, and provide multiple values. Number one on the list is NetFlow. NetFlow is a ubiquitous data source. It's almost like the phone record for the internet, but it's problematic when NetFlow is being generated from core infrastructure, because core infrastructure does not prioritize it, so the data quality is low and often sampled. It can also cause some performance degradation on the core infrastructure itself. So when Gigamon makes the net flow, we're deriving it from network traffic in a passive way, and we can provide it in a high fidelity way so that all flows are captured. This makes net flow something useful for security use cases. The other capability Gigamon has is to derive metadata in the form of a system log that's derived from network traffic. We can do that with over 5,000 unique data elements. DNS is the most important for M21-31. DNS is also problematic. A customer of mine told me that they turned on all of the M21-31 requirements for DNS logging and crashed their DNS server. So we can provide the same information, protect the speed, performance, and stability of a DNS server, but we can also provide that DNS from anything that's not being logged because it's shadow IT, or even worse, malware IT. And the other benefit I would say is that we're looking at DNS from the perspective of the Gigamon, closer to the endpoints. What this means is that we can provide the DNS information in a way that's not confused or obfuscated with network address translation and port address translation. So you don't have to worry about correlating data as much. This is especially important if you're using external services for your DNS. Lastly, Gigamon acts as a force multiplier for any technology that's ingesting packets for its analytics. Specific to M2131, we have the long-term packet capture requirement. I'm not exaggerating when I say that Gigamon can reduce the amount of traffic noise going to one of these tool solutions by over 90%. And what this means is that you can use your existing investment, expand its range into east-west physical, cloud, virtual networks in such a way that you don't have to forklift upgrade to scale up to the requirements of M2131. And we can do this in a way that doesn't sacrifice the forensic integrity of that information. This works with other packet-based technologies as well, for instance, data loss prevention.
Fantastic, thank you. So in a nutshell, Gigamon meets requirements by, number one, we talked about generating flow logs from any medium in your network. Number two, we gave an example of DNS logs, but we can do a lot more than that, utilizing metadata that's generated from network traffic. And number three, reducing data noise significantly without the loss of forensic integrity. So that's very useful for your packet capture solutions and other tools. Now, if you have any technical questions, we're making our solutions engineers available to you. And the email is publicsector.se@gigamon.com. Reach out to us if you have any questions about M2131 or the solution we showed to you. We also have lots of cybersecurity resources at our Gigamon Federal webpage. And because Gigamon has been a trusted provider to the US government for a long time, our resources, I'm sure you'll find, are extensive. So check out the URL that's on your screen. Want to thank you. And on behalf of Matt Hollingsworth and myself, Darshan Shah, we hope to hear from you soon. Thanks.
Thank you.